Good morning, students. Coming back to the chapter number system. Today we are going to see operations on real numbers, where real numbers are comprised of rational and irrational. So we are going to see some operational work on rational and irrational numbers. So coming to that, we are going to see some properties which includes the operations of rational and irrational numbers. The first property, sum of rational number and irrational number is always an irrational number. For example, if I take a rational number and an irrational number, if I sum of those two numbers, so where I get the result as an irrational number. Second property, difference of rational number and irrational number is always an irrational number. For example, 3 minus root 2, where my result will be 3 minus root 2, so which is an irrational number. Third property, product of rational number and irrational number is always irrational. For example, if I multiply a rational number 3 with irrational number root 2, I will get the result as 3 root 2, which is an irrational number. Fourth property, quotient of a rational number and an irrational number is always an irrational number. So if you divide a rational number by an irrational number, you will be getting the quotient as an irrational number. So we are going to use this property in the coming exercise. Now we'll see type 2 properties of irrational numbers. So here we are going to see property 1, sum of two irrational numbers need not be an always irrational number. If you take two irrational numbers, that is 5 plus root 2 and 5 minus root 2. If you add these two irrational numbers, we get the answer as 10, where minus root 2 plus root 2 gets cancelled. So we get 5 plus 5, which is equal to 10. So 10 is a rational number. So I can say that sum of two irrational numbers need not be always an irrational number. Now coming to the second property, difference of two irrational numbers need not be always an irrational number. For example, if we take two irrational numbers, that is 5 plus root 2 and 3 plus root 2, if I subtract these two irrational numbers, I will get 5 plus root 2 minus of 3 minus root 2. So plus root 2 minus root 2 gets cancelled, 5 minus 3, which is equal to 2. So 2 is an rational number. So I can say that difference of two irrational number need not be always an irrational number. It can be a rational number also. Now coming to the third one, product of two irrational numbers need not be always an irrational number. For example, I am taking the two irrational numbers 3 plus root 2 and 3 minus root 2. If I multiply, I will get, I am using the identity a plus b into a minus b, I will get a squared minus b squared, so which is equal to 9 minus of 2, which is equal to 7, where 7 is a rational number. So I can say this property, the product of two irrational number need not be always an irrational number. It can be a rational number also. Now coming to the fourth property, quotient of two irrational numbers need not be always an irrational number. For example, I am taking two irrational numbers, 3 root 2 and 2 root 2. If I divide, where root 2 gets cancelled, I will get 3 by 2, which is a rational number. So I can say this property, the quotient of two irrational numbers need not be always an irrational number, it can be a rational number also. We are going to use the type 1 property and type 2 property in the coming exercise. Now coming to exercise 1.5, the first problem, classify the following numbers as rational or irrational. So here we are going to use the property what we studied in type 1 or in type 2. So the first problem is 2 minus root 5. So as we studied in type 1, the difference of the rational and the irrational is always an irrational. So whose result will be an irrational number. Now coming to the second problem, it's given 3 plus root 23 minus of root 23. So actually plus root 23 minus root 23 gets cancelled. You will be having 3, where 3 is a rational number. Now going to the third problem, 2 root 7 divided by 7 root 7. So as we studied in the property, the quotient of the irrational by an irrational number will give an rational number, that is root 7. Root 7 gets cancelled, so you will be having 2 by 7, which is a rational number. Second problem, simplify each of the following expressions. So here he has given the first problem, the product of 3 plus root 3 and 2 plus root 2. Here we are going to do an ordinary multiplication and we are going to simplify. So I am just multiplying 2 with 3, I will get 6, 2 into root 3, 2 root 3. Again going to the next number, root 2 into 3, it becomes 3 root 2. Root 2 into root 3, it becomes root 6. So I got 6 plus 2 root 3 plus 3 root 2 plus root 6. Going to the second problem, it's given that the product of 3 plus root 3 and 3 minus root 3. So this is of the form a plus b into a minus b. So I'm using the identity, which is equal to a squared minus of b squared. So in place of a I have 3, in place of b I have root 3. So using identity I got a squared minus of b squared. So 3 squared 9 minus root 3 the whole square becomes 3. So 9 minus 3 is equal to 6. Thus I simplified this expression. Now we define what is rationalization. The process of converting irrational number to rational number by multiplying the irrational number with rationalizing factor is called rationalization. So I will show this by an example. The rationalizing factor, which is root 3, so that if I multiply 2 root 3 into root 3, I will get 6, which is a rational number. So my root 3 here is called as a rationalizing factor. And coming to example 2, suppose if I take an irrational number where 3 plus root 2, if I multiply with 3 minus root 2, I will get 9 minus 2 using identities, which is equal to 7. So this is an rational number. Thus this irrational number can be converted into a rational number by multiplying with a rationalizing factor, where here my rationalizing factor is 3 minus root 2. Now we are going to see rationalizing the denominator in the fraction, where the denominator is given in terms of irrational number. So we are going to find how to rationalize the denominator, that is making an irrational number into a rationals. So the first step, multiply numerator and denominator by radical, that will get rid of the radical in the denominator. So radical is nothing but the root of a number. Second one, make sure all radicals are simplified, that is all roots of numbers are simplified. So coming to the example, so if I take the fraction 1 by root 2. That is, we have the denominator as root 2. So, I want to rationalize the denominator. That is, I want to make my denominator in terms of a rational number. So, I am going to multiply and divide with root 2 and root 2. So, I will multiply 1 into root 2, root 2. Root 2 into root 2 becomes 2. So, I rationalized my denominator. Now, coming to the example 2, suppose if it is given as 1 by 2 plus root 3. So, here I want to multiply and divide by its conjugate. So, conjugate is nothing but the opposite sign of the given denominator. So, I am multiplying 2 minus root 3 and with the numerator and 2 minus root 3 with the denominator. So, if I multiply numerator into numerator, I will get 2 minus root 3. Denominator with the denominator, I will get 4 minus 3. So, which is equal to 2 minus root 3 by 1. So, hence I rationalized the denominator here. Fifth problem, rationalize the denominator of the following. First problem, it's given that to rationalize 1 by root 7. So, we are multiplying the numerator and the denominator by root 7. I will get 1 by root 7 into root 7 by root 7. So, if I multiply the numerator, I will get root 7. Multiply the denominators, I will get root 7 into root 7 is equal to 7. So, hence I rationalized the denominator. Now, coming to the second problem. So, the second problem, it's given that 1 by root 5 plus root 2. Here, I want to rationalize my denominator. So, I am going to take the conjugate of this number. So, 1 by root 5 plus root 2, I am multiplying this with the conjugate root 5 minus root 2, multiplying with the numerator and the denominator, its conjugate. So, we get into root 5 minus root 2 by root 5 minus root 2. So, if I multiply the numerator terms, I will get root 5 minus root 2 and the denominator, I will get 5 minus 2. So, that I will be getting root 5 minus root 2 by 3. Hence, I rationalized the denominator. Now, coming to the next exercise, laws of exponents for real numbers. So, this related to the laws which you have studied in exponents and powers, the same procedure we are going to follow for the real numbers. Let a is greater than 0 be a real number and p and q be a rational numbers. Then we have the certain laws. The first law, a power p into a power q is equal to a power p plus q. The second one, a power p the whole power q, which is equal to a power p into q. The third law, a power p divided by a power q, which is equal to a power p minus q. The fourth law, a power p into b power p, which is equal to ab the whole power p. We are going to use these four laws in our exercise problem to simplify. Exercise 1.6, the first problem, find 64 to the power of half. So, here I am going to use any one of the laws in exponents of real numbers. So, here since it is a single number to the power, so I prefer of using the law a power p the whole power q is equal to a power p into q. So, I want to bring my 64 as a power p. So, here I am writing my 64 as 8 power 2 the whole power half. So, now I bought this as a power p into q. So, which is equal to a power P into Q. So that 2, 2 gets cancelled. I will be having 8 power 1, which is equal to 8. Second subdivision, 32, the whole power 1 by 5. So I am going to use the same law, A power P into the whole power Q is equal to A power PQ. So I want to bring my 32 in terms of A power P. So I have to take a LCM for this 32 so that I can get the 2 power 5 is equal to 32. So I am writing 32 as 2 power 5 the whole power 1 by 5. So which is equal to 2 power 5 into 1 by 5. 5, 5 gets cancelled. I will have 2 power 1 which is equal to 2. Second problem. Find 9 to the power of 3 by 2. Here I am going to use a law. A power P the whole power Q is equal to A power P into Q. Since my power whose denominator is of 2, I am making this number as a number to the power of 2. So 9 can be written as 3 power 2 the whole power 3 by 2. So that my 2, 2 gets cancelled easily. So I will get 3 power 2 into 3 by 2. 2, 2 gets cancelled. I will be having 3 power 3 which is equal to 27. Coming to the third problem. 16 the whole power 3 by 4. The same law, A power P the whole power Q. So I am going to use here. Since my power whose denominator is of 4, I am making this 16 as a number to the power of 4. So I am writing this as 2 power 4 the whole power 3 by 4. So here 4 into 3 by 4 by using the law. So 4, 4 gets cancelled. I will be getting 2 power 3 which is equal to 8. Third problem. Simplify 2 to the power of 2 by 3 into 2 to the power of 1 by 5. So I'm going to use the first law here. So A power P into A power Q is equal to A power P plus Q. So since my base are same here, I'm writing 2 to the power of 2 by 3 into 2 to the power of 1 by 5. I am applying this law of exponents of real numbers. So I will be getting 2 to the power of 2 by 3 plus 1 by 5. So I am going to simplify this. So I am going to take a LCM where 3 and 5, my LCM will be 15. So 5 numerator multiplying with 5. So here with the 3 numerator multiplying with 3, I will get 10 plus 3 to the power of 2 by 10 plus 3 by 15. So I will be getting 2 to the power of 13 by 15. Hence I simplify. Problem 1 by 3 power 3 the whole power 7. So I am going to use the law A power P the whole power Q which is equal to A power P into Q. So I am going to take this 3. I am going to write this as a common, that is 1 by 3 the whole power 3. So the whole power 1 by 3 the whole power 3 the whole power 7. So this is of the form A power P the whole power Q. So which is equal to A power P into Q which is equal to A power PQ, that is 3 into 7 which is 21.